Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. I hope you had a wonderful Christmas and a lovely Boxing Day, if you celebrate Boxing Day, we do here. I just want to say, I am doing personal reading, so you can find the information down in the description box down below. If you're new here, please consider to subscribe to my channel, I would love to have you. And I just want to say I appreciate every single one of you that's helping my channel grow. I didn't think it was possible really. Been doing this for years, but never thought I could take it to, you know, YouTube. I'm quite shy really, so yeah, was nervous starting it, but now I'm all right with it. So yeah, enough babbling. So what we're going to do is we're going to get messages from the heart, so it could be from anyone, and then go from there. Okay guys, so it's a collective reading, and it's general, so yeah, I'm going to shut up now. And don't forget their energies, one more thing. So if the King of Swords comes out, that can be female as well, guys, because we all are energies, okay? So spirit, angels, ancestors, what message do you have for the collective today from someone close to their heart? We've got one straight away. Divine blueprint. They are going within to find their higher purpose and discover the meaning of life and this connection. So you could be dealing with someone that's, I don't know why, picked up like Buddhism or someone that's into religion, but not religion like God, if you know what I mean. That believes more in the divine, you know, and the universe and things like that. And maybe you've had this connection that's blown them away, that they're going within to like maybe think about things. Maybe they feel like you're their twin flame. You got any more spirits? Get a few more. So what do we have here? We have coming apart, meeting you was unexpected. You changed their whole world forever, feeling loss as they lose their old identity. Yeah, you've awakened something within this person. This is what I'm saying. I feel like they're looking more to the, that's what I'm trying to say. They're looking more into their spiritual side of your relationship, your connection. Not in, you know, the practical way that you would look at a connection here. I don't know, it's something that you've triggered something in them. Like I said, maybe you could be twin flames here. And I feel like you've affected them that much that they've actually, because I'm picking up hermit vibes here as well, is that they've gone off to think about this. Unspoken love. They've been carrying a torch for you all alone, but unable to confess their love due to their fear of rejection. So for some of you, it could be, this could even be a friend of yours that you've got such a close bond with them, but they fear that you would reject them if they tell you that they've got these deep feelings for you. Maybe you're not even aware of this, guys, you know. And then we have missing you. Their life feels empty without you. They miss you more than words can say, but they think it's too late to fix things. So like I said at the a minute ago about the hermit vibe here, I feel like they've distanced themselves from you, because I feel like they don't know how to deal with this, how to express themselves, how, you know, maybe they feel like they might freak you out if they say that I've, you know, have this divine, like that divine blueprint there, like this connection with you. Oh, this is complicated. It's very sad, actually. Okay, let's have a look. Coming apart. Tell me more about coming apart, spirit. Let's clarify these cards. Oh, okay. So we have the Princess of Coins, and that's the Page of Coins, and the Eight of Coins. Yeah, so this is someone that you can actually depend upon, someone that you can, that is very loyal to you, you know, they wouldn't backstab you, they'd be there for you if they if you needed them. And I am picking up friendship vibe here. I'm picking up that you two have this connection here that's more friendship, you know, but there's a bond there with each other. But the thing is as well, this is also about good news. It's also about, you know, receiving a message or a phone call, you know, wanting to send a message. I can't even fucking pronounce that properly. And this energy here, like, coming apart, they've done a lot of internal thinking here, you know, in a reflection and all that kind of thing that they're doing at the moment. And they've been working really hard on themselves. Yeah, I feel like you scare them. Maybe they could be someone younger than you, or they could be someone that is, you know, they could be older, but they have that carefree, childlike side to them, is what I'm picking up. So we have Earth sign here, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, and on the back of the deck we actually have the Queen of Wands here, which is fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Now they see you as someone that is very beautiful, because the Queen of Wands, she's very stunning, she's very attractive. They find you, you know, very strong, and when you're passionate about something, you know, they love that about you. They see you as someone that is very confident, and I think that is might be where the fear comes in with this energy here, is that they're scared because they feel like you're stronger than them, that you may just cut them down, because look at her wand here. So let's have a look. Tell me about this unspoken love here. Tell me about this unspoken love, Holy Spirit. Okay. So we've got balance. I think that's temperance. We've got Hermit, so I just said Hermit vibe here. We've got Hermit, we've got the Five of Swords, we've got the Prince of Wands, and we've got the Six of Cups. Yeah, look, I do feel like you've been friends for a long time. You've had, like, you could have even grown up together, and their feelings developed into love for you. But also it could be that they've been carrying this torch around for you for a very long time. Now we're talking about unspoken love here, and this is what I'm saying, they've never expressed that love to you. Very sad. So we've got Temperance, and then we've got the Hermit. So with this unspoken love here, you bring them a lot of inner peace. You know, you actually balance out their mind, you balance them out as a person. You know, you are their, I'm hearing you are their rock. You know, like I said, you're dependable, you can rely on them, they can rely on you, you know, you've always been there for them. And then we've got the Hermit here. And then the Five of Swords, which makes a lot of sense here about the unspoken love. It's like, I feel like maybe you haven't seen them for a while, because I said that reminded me of the Hermit card up there. So it could be that you haven't seen them for a while. They've gone within to think about a lot of things, to hopefully come forward and communicate with you that how they're feeling. You know, trying to find that strength here, trying to find that balance here, that they don't end up messing things up. So they've gone Hermit mode on you. They've gone within, they're doing a lot of soul searching, a lot of thinking. And this is quite sad, really, because a part of them thinks that maybe it's best that this is just not going to go anywhere, that it's best to just leave it and just walk away from how they're feeling, walk away from their feelings, even maybe walk away from you. Hopefully that's not the case. But they're feeling defeated here, that it's like it's a one-sided love, that you're not going to return their love, is what I'm picking up here, guys. And then you've got the Prince of Wands. The Prince of Wands is someone that comes with good news, swift news. We've got two news cards here we have. We've also got Sagittarius energy here. And we've also got Virgo energy here as well, guys. So yeah, this is someone that wants to bring forward some communication with you, you know, and it's usually good news as well. And it's someone that it's doing a lot of thinking, doing a lot of inner reflection here, doing a lot of planning. You know, they don't want to mess it up. They don't want to mess things up with you because you have a history together. You know, you have a long history together with this person. But this is all about reconciliation as well. It's like, you know, someone coming back into your life as well. So it could be, like I said, that you've not seen them for a while. They may have just blown you off. You may have felt like, well, what have I done? They've not communicated to you what, you know, why they've distanced themselves from you. But see, this is the thing, I'm stuttering here, and I feel like this person gets very nervous around you, and like they stutter over their words, or it's like they can't communicate with you properly because you make them so nervous, because I'm usually one that just yabbers on, you know. So that could be their energy when they're around you, is that they stutter a lot around you, you know, they fall over their words. And they can't get it out, is what I'm picking up here. They're so fearful of getting it out and telling you how they feel. So, yeah, this is... they have a lot of love for you here, guys. So what's this card here? Yeah, let's have a look at missing you. But this does clarify, these cards here, that this person's disappeared from you. You know, they've, you've not had much communication, if anything, no communication at all. And yeah, I do feel like you're very confused about it. So let's have a look at this missing you. Tell me more about this missing you spirit. Coins. See, look, the Ten of Coins, it's a lovely card. This is like, you know, generational wealth. This is a pure abundance. This is a future with someone that, you know, brings you nothing but joy and abundance and security and family. And I do feel like this person sees you as family, and that might be why they're so fearful of, you know, losing you, if they tell you how they feel. But also the part of them really, really does want this with you. So maybe when they come and communicate with you, they're going to come and tell you that they want their Ten of Pentacles with you. Tell me about this Ten of Pentacles. You know, this is an abundant future here. It's wealth. And, you know, stability that you pass down to your children, and then you can pass that on to their, well, they'll pass it on to their children, you know. Tell me more about, oh, no, that's too many spirit. Tell me more about this Ten of Coins. Tell me more about this Ten of Coins. Tell me about this Ten of Coins, spirit. There we go, finally. Five and eight. Oh. Oh, okay. Alright, take what resonates, check out what's not, you know, for you. But I've got a funny feeling, you guys, collective, you come from you come from generational wealth, you come from money, you come from security, you come from money that's been handed down through generations, you know. And this is not a bad thing, this, you know, this is a bloody good thing for you guys. But what I feel that is the problem is here, is that this energy here does not, and they know that either they feel that they're not good enough for you, that they can't offer you this Ten of Pentacles, which is not true. They can offer this Ten of Pentacles to you. You could both have the Ten of Pentacles together. But I feel like there's a problem here when it comes to you guys, collective, that you, either you or them, their family will not agree with this connection here because of the generational wealth, because of the money here, because of you know, picking up old money. And whoever it is, so like I said, take what resonates. It could be you guys. I'm picking up more you guys, the collective, than this energy here. That if you were to get involved with this person, it will cause such a big backlash with people getting involved. It will cause arguments. It will cause fights within family, fights with friends. You know, they will. It's like they don't agree. They would never agree to this union with both of you, which is bloody sad. You know, the Eight of Swords is, you know, horrible card in the deck. It's mental illness. It's feeling trapped. It's feeling like you can't get out of this. There's no way out of any of this. And this is what this energy is feeling. It could even be this is the way you're feeling. It could be, but I feel like the Eight of Swords is more their energy here, that they know they're trapped. They know that there's no way forward. There's no way, you know, there's no way around this, you know. Tell me more about this Five of Wands here, please, Spirit. Just took a weird turn. Tell me more about this Five of Wands. Tell me more about the Five of Wands. Right, you know what? I'll take that one. Illusion. Oh. Why is the moon here? We have Pisces energy here. With me, guys, tell me more about the moon. Thank you. Justice. Tell me more about the moon and justice. So I have Libra energy as well. Tell me more about that. Ten of Cups, Six of Wands, the Nine of Coins, and the King of Arrows, which is King of Swords, air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Just bear with me, guys. So we're clarifying the five of Wands, which is conflict, arguments, outside influences. Right, from what I'm picking up here, guys, with the moon, with the Five of Wands, you keep your, this energy keeps their feelings buried, you know, very deeply, their feelings for you, you know, their emotions, they keep it so buried deep within, you know, and it's like it's festering, is what I'm hearing. And they keep that hidden from you is because they don't want this Five of Wands for you. They don't want to bring this to your doorstep, basically. They don't want conflict for you because they do really love you. And they know if they were to reveal to you about their feelings and was to change the dynamic of the relationship between both of you, you would end up with the Five of Wands. Now we've got justice here, but the problem with this, Spirit is telling this, and I feel like I'm going to clarify this card. I feel like this is why they've gone away to think about this, is because Spirit is saying to them, you need to take back control, basically. You need to take control of your life here. It's all about speaking the truth and making a decision and sticking with it, you know. And I feel like this is what this person really wants to do, and I do feel like they are going to do it They are going to come and tell you how they feel, even though there may be the consequences of this, but this is something that they need to do. You know, they've been holding on to this, these deep feelings for you for so long, and it needs to come out, basically. And then we've got the Six of Wands. Six of Wands speaks of victory, so hopefully they would feel, you know, good about themselves when they do speak to you about it. You know, maybe the outcome isn't what they expected, maybe you will reject them, but they're going to feel like a weight has been lifted off their shoulders when it comes to this. This energy here is single at the moment, but the thing that's missing at the moment is that 10th pentacle, which is love, which is that 10 of pentacles right there. You know, they're doing well financially for themselves. They have a really good life. But you are missing from their life, that 10th coin. And then we have the King of Swords. The King of Swords is... this energy here that I'm picking up on, because we haven't really had their energy come through except for yours, mainly how they see you, which was the Queen of Wands. Now, they are someone that is, you know, they don't wear their heart on their sleeves. They keep it hidden. They keep their emotions hidden from you, and that's with the Moon card there. So it's like an illusion, basically. They do have deep feelings for you, is what I keep saying. But the King of Swords... he's very intelligent, he's very logical, he's very practical, he will think about things before he acts. This is someone that's in a high position here, someone that could be in authority, someone that's got a high position, you know, paying job, you know, people work underneath him, and this is what I'm saying, they're single, they're doing really well for themselves. But this is someone that is very honest, and I do feel like they're coming forward to be honest with you. You know, they see you as their happily ever after. They see you as their 10 of Cups. They see family and home life with you, love, you know, security, growing old together is what I see here. And they see this can be a success if that's what you want. We've got the Ace of Wands here. This is a passionate new beginning. This is Spirit saying, and there is a chance of, you know, there's a second chance here to do it right. Then this is what this energy, this King of Swords really wants to do here, is to make it right, to go for what he's really passionate about here. But this card, I need to clarify this card. Tell me about this divine blueprint, please, Spirit. Tell me about, thank you. We have the Three of Coins and the Four of Coins. Yeah, look, they can't let you go here. It's like you're embedded in their soul, if you know what I mean. It's like you're in their blood. I know that sounds quite, like, weird, but that's what I'm picking up, and it's like they can't let you go. They cannot let... Look at this man here, standing here, the way he watches her. So it's like he's constantly thinking about her, but she's also constantly thinking about him, because he's like a dream figure in the background there. But he can't let go. He holds you so close to his heart, and it's like, you know, there's even a bit of possessiveness here. But yeah, just picking up that this person really holds you in such high regard, you know. If anything, they put you on a pedestal. You know, the Three of Coins here, this is a collaboration, this is speaking with other people, it's communicating with other people. It could be that they're trying to find answers within, like, you know, this is the divine blueprint that says they're going within to find their higher purpose and discover the meaning of life and this connection, and this is what they're doing. And I feel like they could even be talking to special people that deal with this kind of, you know, spiritual side of things. Or it could be they're doing a lot of meditation here. And they're coming to the realization that they really do hold you close to their heart, and they can't let you go. You've got communication coming towards you guys here. You've got the Eight of Swords here. You've got communication that's coming quite swiftly towards you. They're going to be reaching out. We've already had the page cards here, which is all about communication here. So they will be reaching out. They will be telling you how they feel. And I feel like they are going to take that risk with you. So let's get some advice here. What advice do you have for the collective spirit in regards to the situation? Oh, I'm going to take that because that flipped. Nine of Cups is all about success. It's all about fulfillment. It's all about, you know, feeling blessed. Oh no, it's not the Nine of Cups. Sorry, the King of Cups. Fucking tripping out there. But then again, I said that. So, you know, it's the King of Cups. Same sort of thing. This is someone that is so, like... Can I explain it? This is someone that is grieving over you. It's the King of Cups is someone that is very loving, very loyal. And this is someone that is very... compassionate towards others as well. You know, they have this soft side to them. They have this really warm, caring side to them. You know, very affectionate. And I do feel like this person's very affectionate towards you. But they're in the Nine of Arrows, which is the Nine of Swords. This is someone that just stays up late at night thinking about you, missing you, grieving. And they're feeling like, if I was to tell this, the collective, how I feel, you know, what is the outcome? Is it going to get any worse? But Spirit wants you to know that this energy here has a lot of feelings for you. And, you know, the love runs quite deep. Any more advice? What advice do you have? So we have the King of... How, look at this, the Ace of Cups. This energy is, can't let you go. And we've got the King of Wands now. So this is someone that, like I said, is so passionate about you, is so determined to come towards you and ask for this chance at love, you know, ask for... Look, Ten of Cups again, guys. They're going to come forward to communicate with you that they want a second chance or a chance with you. And this is your advice from Spirit. Spirit is saying that maybe give this person a chance if that's how you feel. Because you've got this beautiful Ten of Cups here. You know, you've got this love, this commitment. And look at the way in this card as well, you know, like I said, with this card as well here, the way he's looking at her. Then you've got this card here, the way he's drawing her here. It's like you're constantly on his mind or her mind. You know, and it's getting to the point of obsession. And I don't mean that in a creepy way. I just mean that it's like it's nothing else. You know, it's like this energy's got to get it out. We'll just get a little bit more advice from you from Spirit here. You know, this is exactly like this blueprint card. They're doing a lot of contemplation. They're doing a lot of inner reflection. They're thinking about, you know, how to deal with this, how to tell you, what to say. So what more advice do you have for the collective Spirit? What advice do you have? That was the Eight of Wands there that flew out with a whole load of cards again. That they're going to be reaching out to you. They are going to be communicating with you. Ace of Cups again. Looking at. Four of Cups. Two of Arrows. So they're so fearful that you're going to reject them. Because the Four of Cups is rejection. It's all about boredom. It's feeling rejected. But I feel like Spirit is saying... it may confuse you when they do come forward to tell you how they feel here, because with the Two of Swords, it's feeling conflicted. It's feeling like you're going to feel blindsided. It's going to be like, where the hell did this come from? But that's their fear here, is the rejection. You know, when they tell you, are you going to reject them? There's the Ace of Cups again. I feel like spirit is screaming, yeah, look at this, you've got the lovers here. I feel like spirit is screaming, and before I said that, before I saw that, was what I was going to say was, give this person a chance. You know, but everyone's got free will, you do what you want. If you don't like this person like that, you know, don't force yourself to be with someone, you know. But look at this. Look at this here. We've got the lovers, we've got the Ace of Cups, we've got the Three of Cups, you've got the Ace of Coins. Do you know what, guys? You've got such a beautiful future with this person here if you were, you know, ballsy to take it, if that's what you really wanted, okay? But the choice is yours. The choice is down to you at the end of the day. They choose you, but it's up to you whether you want to choose them. Now you've got the Three of Cups here. This is celebrations. This is could be weddings, it can be anniversaries, it can be celebrating birthdays. So you will be doing some kind of celebrating here with this energy here. So I hope, you know, maybe you might take them up on their offer, but you've got this abundant future in, you know, this abundant future ahead of you guys. You've got security, you've got wealth, you've got a new home, a new start. It's all about just pure abundance. Look at this coin here. Success. But I see this more success for this connection here. And you know, and if that's what you want to do, guys, you take it. Hang on, what are these? Let me just gather a couple of these little messages before I close. So what closing messages do you have for the collective? I was going to close it there until I saw these. Hang on. What closing messages do you have? Thank you. Pain. Look at this. Apprehensive, afraid, cautious. This person is in so much pain. I mean, I've been saying that throughout the whole reading, but they're so afraid to tell you how they feel. So they're doing it. They are very cautious about doing it because of the backlash that may come with this. Or even the rejection, you know, you rejecting them. So if you do reject them, do it nicely, guys, please. This is a really nice energy here that I'm picking up on. And I don't really get nice energies that come through. So look, hoping on the back of the deck.